Oh, we just waited for Anna. She's just coming in. Won't be sick.
Okay. All right. What are we talking about then?
You.
Have you seen my fish, my goldfish?
No.
Can you see them?
No.
No, I can see the tank.
Yeah.
Down a bit. They're lovely.
Yeah.
They're beautiful.
We're looking hello, at Anna. We're looking at Bobby's goldfish. Nothing
lovely.
Rude. Nothing rude. We're just looking at his goldfish.
Oh, they're lovely. Are they? They're not gold. They're more than goldfish, aren't they?
They're piranhas. I've sent all the ones to my ex-wife. Got piranhas, blue ringed octopus, box jellyfish, sharks. Hello, Anna.
Hi there, Bobby. Nice to meet you.
I'm a bit outnumbered in the feminine department.
I know.
Go and stick a dress on.
That's better.
Yeah, I think you should. I think you look lovely in a dress.
I've got going next week to have my my penis reduction operation. third time lucky. Third time lucky, as I say.
Oh, I knew we'd get onto that.
Don't take me long.
Well, it's all polite. We looked at your goldfish and now it's started with penises. I knew it was.
I'm going to take my glasses off. the reason why I'm wearing a cap, you mustn't laugh, I've taken my hat off. My son-in-law, future son-in-law, cut my hair with one of those clipper things and he's cut it all off.
Oh my God!
I've had the COVID cut.
You're quite lucky.
You know the salons are open again, don't you?
Oh, goodness, yeah.
Bobby, I have to ask you, you was obviously, you came to like on our screens in 1980s. Even on our screens, like, what is the secrets? Because I like, everyone knows who Bobby is and you make everybody laugh. Like, how did you do it?
I'll tell you something, Lisa. I haven't been on television. I'm a bit frustrated, really, because my sort of career started well in the late 80s and then it sort of dissolved into nothing. And now you can't get on the television unless you go wood straighten a floor, bake a cake or dig your garden up. You can't get on. I can't skate, I can't dance, I can't cook, I haven't got a garden, I've got bugger all in the attic, so I stand no chance, really.
Oh, Bobby.
I would love to have done some lovelier things. I would like to. I did some game shows back in the sort of early 90s.
Yeah.
And I wanted to sort of get on and do everything, but it sort of went awry, you know, it went wrong. I don't know where it went wrong, really. It's just, I think it was fashion. People came in from a different generation. All the modern comics, you know, the Michael McIntyres, you know, people like that, yes. John Vittich. They've taken over now, and I can't get back on. It's a shame because I don't feel as I'm past it. I feel as I'm.
You're not.
Past it. You're so witty.
Yeah, you're.
It's absolutely brilliant. I think the difficult point is we're in the same sort of boat, you and I, Bobby, in that I'm lucky that, you just mentioned the cooking, the digging, and that I can do the cooking things. But what's happened to you and I, both really, is that, you know, the cruises and things that you would probably be doing now.
I've done some good cruises. I've done some work for Royal Caribbean.
Yes.
And so that's been all right. But with the lockdown, yes. I hadn't had a gig really for a year.
Well, same here, you see, because we do live and our audiences come out to see us. So, for instance, my cookery demos all cancelled. But I've just had a cruise come again from a different company that I've never worked with. Oh, just come online. And what they're doing is they'll be doing in this country. So it'll be like a 3 or 4 days cruise around the British Isles and that. So, yeah. I've had that come through, which is fantastic. So, you know, it is opening up again. You'll have to talk to my Andreas, Bobby, see what he can get you on that.
It's very difficult, Rusty. The cruise work is a bit click. I never really wanted to be a cruise act. Always wanted to be a touring act. I've got quite a big show with you know, videos and pictures and all the material. And it's a good 2-hour show.
Yes.
And it's just that I can't get people to come in the theatres anymore because I'm not on the television. I'm not popular anymore on the television. So consequently, you get forgotten. And that's sad.
Yeah.
And it's and this year's been dreadful because not only have I lost my business, I lost my father too.
Oh, sorry.
He passed away.
That is terrible. Oh, I'm so sorry.
Well, he was 95. And
it doesn't make any difference, really, with the age. Yeah. It's the same situation with the Duke going. Yeah. You know, he's always been there. You don't see an age, do you? So your dad being 95, it's still very sad and it still takes your heart, doesn't it?
Oh, it really did break my heart. You know, I loved him. We were he's my best friend, Rusty. But, you know, I'm missing him. So it's been a pretty crappy year. I was going to say another word, but I'm going to clean.
We get the message.
Yeah,
I've been very lucky.
Bobby, you were on EastEnders, though, weren't you, for like a year? Like, how did that, you know, that must have been really great for your career. So I didn't even realise you was an actor as well. You literally have got it all.
That's it?
Yeah.
Well, it was nice. The only thing is I had to kiss Shirley. They made Shirley Carter my girlfriend. And I'm not being cruel to her. She's a lovely lady. It's Shirley. I still stay in touch with a few of the EastEnders, Steve McFadden, and the girl that played Shirley's girlfriend, Heather.
Heather. Oh, I liked her. Yeah.
Yeah, she's lovely. She is. And so I stay in touch with her and Jake Wood, I enjoyed EastEnders, but it didn't. They wouldn't let me do corporate work, and they wouldn't let me do anything like pantomimes and stuff, and I couldn't afford it. You know, I don't want to be poor me because that's not attractive.
No, but it's real life. It's what's happening. You know, it's been honest. And that's the thing is, a lot of people, instead of being honest with the situation, they hide it. And then they are in problems after. You have to talk and talk with people and have a chat about things. We'll have a chat after, Bobby. I'd love to have a chat with
you. You've got my number. You just give me a call. I do have a new girlfriend, though, girls. I do have a new girlfriend. And she actually takes my breath away.
Oh.
Yeah, she's inflatable.
Yeah. Ah! Oh, I was getting really excited. I thought, oh,
Rusty, she's the best part of a double act. Rusty, wait. Oh, she bleeds it. She sat out. I had to wait for that. Oh, and then you hit it.
Honestly, Bobby, you've lifted our spirits. You've made us laugh. Just what, you know, just what we needed. You're paratonic.
It's a pleasure. Oh, it's a pleasure. You're beautiful, ladies. And just keep happy and well, because, you know, about 3 years ago, all we were complaining about was the fact that we were leaving the EU. And now we just want to leave the house, and that's what we
do. It's true. It's so true. Oh.
And I just want to get through this. Sorry, Anna?
I say you've got such a lovely way with words. I'd love to work with you,
Bobby, and do something.
Sorry, yeah. Well, thank you, ladies. Well, I'm going to love you and leave you then. Early things.
We'll text you, Bobby.
Please do. Keep well and keep asking the universe and your angels.
Yes.
Indeed.
And keep asking for
anything. Indeed. We'll talk soon.
Lots of love, God. Bobby.
Lots of love.
Bye.
God bless you.
Bye. Sarah, oh, lovely to see you. So we're so privileged to have Dr. Sarah. I can't believe it. The ladies, Sarah has written over 60 books.
Congratulations.
I know. I take life, don't I?
No. And you're the nutrition expert and menopause. And I am petrified of like going through the menopause because, you know, if you get, I have a grumpy day and I'm like, oh, have I started a menopause, haven't I? And like, there's just so many things out there and I'm so scared. And I thought, I'd love your advice, Sarah, you know.
Well, the first thing to do is to ask your other female family members who've been through menopause what they experience, because often it's very similar.
Yes.
About one in four women have very little symptoms at all and they just go through absolutely fine. Another half have symptoms that could be a bit troublesome, but they manage to cope with them. And then about another quarter have symptoms that really do interfere with their life. But we have lots of treatments. We've got medical treatments, HRT, if you're willing and able to take it. We've got herbal medicines. We've got plant isoflavones. So there are lots of options that you can use. You don't have to use HRT and you shouldn't have to suffer.
No. Well, I, for one, suffered and still am at my ripe old age of and I've just went through so much stress, especially being on TV and the lights and everything.
Yeah.
So it was a nightmare. And in the end, I took all the things you've just mentioned, all the I took HRT, and when people were saying, oh, you should take HRT. And then one day I took this HRT and one of my eyes went blind. I couldn't see. And I went to my doctor and he said, oh, that was like a blood clot passing through. You were lucky that it floated on through. And so that frightened me. So I dug deeply into it and I took all the tablets, the phage tablets, the this, the that. Yeah. And I've looked on your site and you do tea, cannabis oil.
CBD, is it? Yeah.
CBD, yes, yeah. You've just done a book.
Would that help people, your CBD oils, with menopause?
CBD is very good for general well-being and relaxation. It can help with anxiety. It does seem to reduce sweats, but there's not much research that's looked into that yet, so I can't say for definite. But certainly for the emotional symptoms, I mean, anxiety is the main symptom that we don't recognise as being due to menopause. And, you know, we think we're going a bit mad. I mean, I went through the menopause 10 years ago, so I'm at the other side now.
Thank God.
And I've used CBD, I use plant isoflavones, altered my diet to make sure I get lots of the natural plant hormones in my food, and I was lucky not to have too many problems. But to begin with, when I wasn't quite sure what was going on, I did think I was going mad. I was, you know, tearing my hair out literally, and and, you know, being aggressive, maybe not aggressive, that's the wrong word, but irritable. As soon as I
not yourself
I addressed it, then I was a lot nicer to live with, I think.
Yeah, that's what you worry about, because you do see relationships break down. And you're bickering, and you know, like, you don't want that to happen. So, so having like HRT, that kind of like that helps, does it, with like, you know, the stress and anxiety?
Well, it's certainly worth talking to your doctor about to see whether it's like to suit you. And obviously, it will depend on your family history, how you feel about natural versus prescribed medicines.
I'm all natural.
Very low doses now. It's not like when we first started prescribing them, when they were really high doses. Now it's done often very tailored based on blood tests. So and there's a lovely tablet called Tibolone, which isn't an estrogen. It's like it's a tablet that has a little bit of a testosterone effect as well. So it's better if you're losing your sex drive, and it is a bit safer maybe than some of the estrogen based ones. But again, that's something you can discuss with your doctor.
Is that a prescription tablet?
It's a prescription tablet. You take one a day. The nice thing is now, if HRT suits you, you can take it for the rest of your life. At one time, we used to say you can take it for 10 years, starting from the age of 50, because we were trying to reduce risks. But now I've seen women in their 90s who are still on HRT.
I am so happy to hear you say that. My late mother had a hysterectomy at 45, and when she died at 89, she was still on the HRT. She did not want to let it go. And without it, I don't think she would have had such a happy and fulfilled and long life, quite frankly.
Young, I think, but you know, for those that can't take it, then plant isoflavones can help as well.
You can help with if perhaps you've got you know, problems or illnesses, and that you can help through nutrition, like the right food. Is that correct?
Yes, I mean, diet always comes first, and that's why I got into nutrition, really, because as a GP, I recognised that lots of my patients were eating pasties, pizzas, fish and chips. This was down in Cornwall and Devon. You know, they weren't seeing a piece of fruit or veg all week. And it wasn't until I started prescribing vitamin and mineral supplements and they perked up that they started to believe that perhaps their diet was at fault.
Yes.
That was in the days when you could prescribe vitamins and minerals on the NHS, which of course you can't now. But that's how I got into nutrition. And, you know, a healthy diet can protect against something like 90% of the illnesses that we commonly experience. Perhaps not in growing toenail, that's probably about the only one.
Or hip replacements.
But getting your five a day fruit and veg, you know, all these messages, although they sound boring because we know them, eating your two portions of fish a week, eating nuts and seeds, Mediterranean style diet, there's so much evidence that it protects against heart disease, stroke, diabetes, cancer, skin conditions, you know, bowel conditions. Yeah, it would be nice if we learned more about this, I think, in schools and had an early grounding and healthy diets and not the fizzy drinks and the crisps and the biscuits and the cakes, etc.
Are you still a practicing doctor? Do people come to see you regularly?
No, or... I've retired. I'm 63, so I've retired from...
Certainly don't look 63. No, you look about 30-something.
You don't. Obviously, very eating well. Yeah, you don't look your age at all.
Good makeup. Well, I take about 12 different supplements every day, so I think...
Really?
Well, yeah.
What do you take? So we can follow your lead.
With your skin looking so great, I'm like, yeah, yes. What do I need? Yeah.
Fabulous.
Yeah. Everything you take has to have a reason. So for most people, you could take an omega-3 fish oil, a multivitamin and mineral designed for your age group, and maybe a probiotic, which is the healthy digestive bacteria. Mm. And those are the good three foundations, if you like. And then on top of that, you might want some extra vitamin D, depending on how much is in your supplement. I take glucosamine because I've got dodgy knees. I take extra vitamin C. I take CBD.
Yeah, nice.
Evening primrose oil for my skin. That's the top tip, actually.
Oh, okay, yes. Oil. Yeah, that's a good one. That.
Oh, even during pregnancy with twins, and that I didn't get a single stretch mark, which I'm very proud
of. Yeah.
And I do think, evening primrose oil keeps your skin very flexible, so I think, and soft. So I think that's why.
I wish I'd known that.
Magnesium.
Terrible stretch
mark. Magnesium.
Yes.
Magnesium. What does the magnesium do?
Well, if you take a magnesium tablet at night, it helps relax. It relaxes muscles. You also have a very nice magnesium moment, as I call it, next day in the bathroom, because it has a very mild laxative effect. Most of the people that I come across who think they've got irritable bowel syndrome or who've got constipation are actually magnesium deficient. It's the commonest deficiency of minerals that we have, because we're eating white flour goods rather than brown, for example, and which was milled out most of the magnesium. So it's very good for mood. It's good for just about everything. It's needed for something like 600 enzymes to work in the body. So it's something that's worth taking. Good for hair as well.
Can I ask it to Sarah? You know, and I know it's not, you know, obviously you should be asking probably my doctor, but should you have bowel movement every day, or is that, I don't, so I just, you know, it's quite.
Yeah, it's a bit of a myth that you need to, but something like 60% of the population do, but it depends what's normal for you. Mm. Women tend to have slower bowel movement or movement of things through the bowel because we have progesterone hormone, which slows things down a bit. So that's why when you're pregnant, you get the most horrendous constipation. It's because of progesterone levels. So it depends what is normal for you. Some people only go every 3 days, some go every other day. It's when you have a change in your bowel habit that you need to perk up and think, oh, what's going on here? Mm-hmm. Unless you've done something like starting magnesium, which might make it a bit more regular. It depends how much fiber you eat in your diet, how much fluid you drink, how much exercise you take. All these things influence the number of times you open your bowels and what they look like when it comes out.
Indeed.
This is amazing. thing called the Bristol Stool Scale. It has little pictures of 8 different types of poo, and it tells you what's good and what's bad.
Something to do with the colour of your urine as well, whilst we're down at that area.
Oh, yes. Well, that will depend partly on what you've been eating, because certain things like beetroot can affect the colour, make it look quite red. The amount of fluid you drink is the main indicator, though, of the colour of your urine. You want to maintain hydration so that your urine's a sort of nice pale straw colour, really. If it's very dark, then it could mean you're dehydrated. It could mean that you have liver problems. So, you know, and if it starts to smell unpleasant, check you haven't been eating asparagus, because you might well have asparagus pee. Otherwise, again, that's something to perhaps, if it continues, take a sample along to your surgery and have it checked.
I also wanted to ask you something about HRT. Mm-hmm. Has the policy changed? Because at one stage, doctors were extremely reluctant to prescribe it because of studies that said it was linked to heightened breast cancer.
Yes, that did change a couple of years ago. There was a big review of all the evidence, and it was decided that evidence was that it was more beneficial than not. Certain people shouldn't take it. So if you've got a strong family history of breast cancer, for example, then you might advise not to. But yes, it was about 3 years ago, maybe. And it was quite good when it came in, because it did give doctors a bit more confidence, because I think a lot of doctors were then afraid when this million women study came out that the results were so negative. But it all depends on relative risk. When you hear that, and it says, oh, taking HRT doubles your risk of breast cancer, that sounds really scary.
It does.
If the risk was, say, 1 in 1 million, and now it's 1 in 500,000, then although it's doubled,
feel safe.
More in perspective, yes.
Yes.
But it's a decision you have to make together with your doctor and having discussions and chatting about it.
Are you going to be putting up on the website all about Dr. Sarah?
Yes, I'd love to. Yeah, we want all the information about Dr. Sarah and your books, because, as you say, that's 60 books. I mean, that's
phenomenal. Wow.
That is incredible.
Yeah.
And all the advice, and I got introduced to Dr. Sarah for a friend of mine, and she's absolutely fabulous, and what she doesn't know isn't worth knowing. So,
all right.
Yeah, we're so grateful to have you here and all the advice. And
pleasure. I'd like to share what I know, and there's lots of interesting facts I can share if you want me on again.
And I think it'd be great, as you say, if anyone has got problems and really struggling, I think it'd be great for them to comment. And then, perhaps if you wouldn't mind coming on again, Dr. Sarah, because you've been so enlightening, and I actually not so scared now about, I don't want to go through the menopause, but I feel like there's light at the end of the tunnel. So.
Yeah,
there is.
Well, it's something we all have to go through. It's better than the alternative of not making that age, isn't it, if you think about it?
Yes, that is true. Yes.
Yeah,
absolutely. Well, thank you so much for joining us. I really appreciate your time.
Lovely meeting you, Dr. Sarah.
And you.
It's been absolutely lovely seeing you, Sarah. Yeah. Absolutely gorgeous.
We must catch up.
Take care. Thanks,
Sarah. Bye.
Bye. Lots of love.
Bye.
Lots of love, yes.
Bye.
Oh, she was lovely, wasn't she?
What a lovely interview.
That was advice.
Excellent.
The girls, what are you doing for the rest of the week? Have you got anything planned?
Not massively. Just enjoying the fact that things feel freer.
Yes, exactly what you feel. And Rusty, you're sometimes like, she's filming here or something.
Yes, I'm not sure. I normally wait to be told what I'm going to be doing, because Andreas manages me, see, so I wait. But in the meantime, I'm just going to enjoy the fact that there's some freedoms that we've got. Perhaps I'll have another beer.
I'll join you.
Husband, you need a beer, don't you?
Yes.
Yeah, as you say, you definitely need a beer. And I think we need to talk out about Bobby doing some cooking with us. That would be fun.
Oh, that would be lovely.
I'm not letting the dog. I'm not bringing the dog. She's nicked my I'm off the radiator.
If you bring the dog, Bobby will be in his element, because that dog Holly will probably go and find some old knickers somewhere again.
Bobby, I don't even want to think of that but thank you, ladies. It's been such a fun week, and looking forward to next week already. Feels like
thank you. Yes, it's been wonderful.
Lots of love to you. Lots of love, Lisa. Bye-bye, Anna.
Bye.
Bye-bye, darling.
Take care.